Welcome to another How It Works with Holger. And why I'm laughing is pretty easy because my wife sitting next to me just sneezed when I was recording this, so I had to repeat everything. So if I'm smiling right now, that's the reason. So this is one I've announced a couple of times. We're going to talk about time and time zones. Very, very important. Even if you think, oh, I've heard all of it before, maybe give me these 10 minutes to explain it all, how it's been implemented in Delphi. It has gotten really, really easy. So back at the simple example, memo field button to tinker, to implement. And we also talked about time span, date utils. Time is part of date utils because, and this is what I get over pretty quickly the last time when I talked about dates, of course, each date contains a time if you declare it as tdate time. And so far we've always used tdate time dot today or yesterday, stuff like that, but you can also do now. And now means that it's the date plus the time. So this is really the moment in time right now. But here's the kicker, and this is where things go wrong. Most of the time, as soon as you use your application all over the world and you compare times that are being created all over the world. If I run this tdate time now and I log this to the memo field ldate to string and let's run this. So this is again February 22nd, 2022. And oh my God, I almost hit it, 5:55 and 56 seconds. Can you believe it? And this is the time here on the East Coast in the United States right now. So if I called my dad right now in Germany, it would be 11:55 p.m. right now. So it depends on where you are, what this value is. So this value is actually determined by the setting on your computer. My computer right now is set to East Coast United States, so the time reflects that. This is all good and well as long as you stay on your own system and even if your database stays on your own system. However, let's assume that I have a shared database with a web service and I send information into the web service stored in the database, and I use now, and my dad does the same thing at the same time. Even though we do things at the same time, I do it at 6 in the evening, and he does it at midnight the next day. So that's definitely not what you want. And of course, I've seen implementations with time zone that is being stored as well. You don't need any of it. You can use UTC or, for the ones who served in the military, Zulu time. And so far, or back in the day, that has been not as easy accessible as it is now. You might have seen we have now UTC, and then you can do ldate to string. Let's see what that returns. So this is the UTC time right now. So this is almost 11 p.m. So that would be compared to Germany. Germany seems to be 1 hour ahead of UTC, and we seem to be a couple of hours behind UTC. Okay, so that is the easiest way to get UTC time with Delphi right now. And this time is comparable all over the world. Easiest way to do it. And this tdate time class helper, I think it's been introduced with Delphi 11. I'm not sure though. But there is also another way to do this, and that is using TTimeZone. TTimeZone is yet another record, not a class. If I'm not mistaken, let's look it up. I do this intentionally, so you see how I look these things up, because I can't remember if something is a class or a record. So we see TTimeZone is actually a class. So TTimeZone dot, and there is a class property called local. And that's exactly what you need in order to put perspective to the time on the system and UTC time, you need the local configuration of your system. And that is exactly what TTimeZone gives you. TTimeZone is not a class that allows you to convert between different time zones. No, if you look at the source code inside of the Delphi RTL, it tells you it TTimeZone is used to gain access to convert between, and here it is, local time and universal time. That is key. So you can't use this to say, oh, what, I'm on the East Coast and another person is on the West Coast. How can I convert between the two? No, that's not what it is. It simply gives you information about the local time zone, how far away it is from UTC. And it also allows you, and this is right here, looking at the public stuff that you can use, you can get the UTC offset. You can convert to universal time if you have a local time on your system, or you can convert UTC time to the local time on the system. Looking back at the example that I just gave between my dad and me, my dad being in Germany, I'm being in the US on the East Coast, if we stored the universal time inside of the database, whenever you read a value from the database, and assuming that the database server doesn't do conversion on its own of some sort, if you have the agreement that inside of the database is universal time, you simply say to local time when you read the value out of the database. And then my dad is going to get midnight right now, and I would get 6 p.m. And that's the magic of TTimeZone, which is part of Delphi now. So to complete this example, ttimezone.local. Now you see to local time, to universal time. There are the two methods that you can use. There's really no necessity to explain how these work. They're straightforward. And, or let me do one. So let's see. L date equals encode. Date, or let's just do now, which is the old method, and this is on my system. So if I want now the L UTC T date time, I could do it like this: L UTC T time zone local to universal time for what? For L date. I could also have used now there, and then if I say log L UTC, I should get the same thing that I got before, 11.02 p.m. Perfect. So you see, these things have been integrated into Delphi that before, I'm thinking like when I started with Delphi, Delphi 2, this wasn't there. You had to use these things or had to implement these things using third-party libraries. This is all now part of Delphi. Very easy to use. And this concludes my excursion about dates and time.